very big night of swimming coming up at the Olympic Park swimming pool where the 88 games are being contested. Olympic gold on the line and probably some world records. The first event of the day will be the 100-meter butterfly for men, in which an American top hope, Matt Biondi, will compete. I'm Don Crickey with John Neighbor. The American team seemed to be ignited by the gold medal performance of Janet Evans a couple of days ago. U.S. swam much better yesterday. And leading off tonight's show, John, we have Biondi going for the gold, but what a field he's against in the fly.
No question about it. It's going to be a thrilling set of championship finals today. In the first four events, the 12 Olympic medals were spread out through 10 different countries. Now, in this series of events, America's done much, much better. They're not their strong events, but we have a realistic shot at three gold medals in the first five events today. And with that in mind, the first event features the 100 butterfly, which is Matt Biondi's chance to win his second medal in his second event.
He has to go against Michael Gross, the West German who won Olympic gold in this event at Los Angeles, called it his perfect race. Matt Biondi's a superstar in swimming, in the water and out. Nobody handles the pressure better. Let's spend a moment in time with Matt Biondi.
Much of the hype and much of the hope for U.S. swimmers has been placed on the very broad shoulders of Matt Biondi. He's a golden bear from the University of California, Berkeley, where swimming is big, but swimmers are not necessarily big time.
I feel that I can walk around and be myself and not have to always live up to the image of being the fastest man in the world. And here at Cal, I can feel like I'm just a basketball player or I'm just a student. And most people ask me if I play basketball. I'm 6'6", and that's always their first question. My wingspan is probably about 6'8". So my arms are a little too long for my body. I got kidded a lot for it when I was young, but it's really a positive physical attribute to have in swimming, to have the longer levers, to be able to pull more water. My whole body is physically built for the water and for aquatic sports.
Though built for his sport, Matt Biondi didn't get serious about swimming until he entered Berkeley. A virtual unknown, he wasn't even supposed to make the 84 Olympic team. He thought his best Olympic shot would be in water polo.
I remember being young and watching Jacques Cousteau, all his specials. And to me, that was really something special, what he did and what he's done for the sea world and sea life. And it was always an attraction there for me. Not to mention the fact that I spend 5 hours a day in the water swimming. Dolphins, to me, are the ultimate in water performance. I'm envious the way they move through the water. I think, as a creature, they exemplify the ultimate in hydrodynamics and underwater capabilities. And I'd be trying to do something with this one dolphin, the other one would be poking me in the neck, and they'll say, hey, what about me, what about me? I think I'm more aware in my swimming because of it. I'm more aware of how the water moves over my body. Watching these dolphins and seeing how perfect they move their body in the water, I can try to simulate that, especially in the butterfly, because the butterfly is the dolphin kick, and nobody does it better than them.
Whether his unique training techniques are viable or just plain fun, how he is perceived by others is not something Matt Biondi is worried about.
Every 4 years, the nation turns to swimming because it's an Olympic event and people like to watch it. And then after the Olympics, it sort of slips underneath the carpet and it comes back out again. Well, in 2 years after the Olympics, I'll slip in the movie theater and everyone will just think I'm a basketball player.
There he is, live, Matt Biondi, as you see, third fastest time in history in the 100-meter butterfly. Michael Gross, you're looking at him, was the man who won gold in this event at Los Angeles. He called it his perfect race.
You know, Don, they call him the albatross because his wingspan is so much longer than his height. Take a look at the two comparisons. Gross at 6'8", has a 6'4 wingspan. Biondi, 2 inches shorter, has a 4-inch shorter wingspan. And if all other things were equal, that would be a 4-inch advantage per stroke in the race. So it's a real interesting matchup coming up.
Another guy you have to look out for is Andy Jamieson of Great Britain. Jameson was the fastest qualifier yesterday, and Jameson is a quietly very confident young man. He likes being an underdog. He's gone against these guys before, swam at Arizona State. He'd like to be the upsetter today.
I'd like to be a spoiler, really. I'd like to mess them all up. I'm not too sure that Michael Gross is really taking it quite as seriously as his other events, and so therefore, I think there could be a couple of different people coming into play. Possibly Jay Mortensen. He swam very well at the trials. I'm not exactly sure whether he can do that again. I'm hoping he can't.
There is the fastest qualifier from Great Britain, Andy Jameson. He is a final length swimmer. The world record is still held by the American Pablo Morales, who failed to qualify for our team this year. Gross set the Olympic record in winning gold at Los Angeles, and the Morales world record, of course, is also the American record. We'll take a look now at the field. It's the best ever assembled for this event. In lane number one from Canada's Tom Ponting. In lane two, and watch out for John Sieben of Australia. His coaches told me a moment ago he's going to win. We'll see. Anthony Nesty of the University of Florida and Suriname is a terrific competitor. Then you have Jameson, Biondi, Gross, Yaroshuk of the Soviet Union, and Jay Mortensen of the United States. Anthony Nesty is a very confident young swimmer and a very good one. He's from a little country called Suriname, which is on the north coast of South America. His dad made him become a swimmer because he liked the discipline. He didn't like the sport. Now he's one of the best in the world in the big races. Got to look out for Anthony Nesty. There's Suriname on the north coast, just north of Brazil in South America. Of course, if he wins, he'll be the first guy, for even medals, he'll be the first to win a medal in swimming for Suriname.
You know, I anticipate a very fast first 50 out of Matt Biondi, but the interesting thing is after that most recent false start, Matt Biondi was slow to the blocks. Andy Jameson got there right away.
Second start is a good one, and Matt Biondi's out quickly, and they feel it's imperative for him to have a great start, and Biondi swimming in the lead by the slightest of margins. Matt Biondi swimming in lane five down from the top. That is Michael Gross now coming up. The man who won gold at Los Angeles. And John Sieben of Australia is indeed going to the wall in good form as they come out of the only turn of the race. 50 meters to swim, and they're faster than a world record split.
Jameson breathing every stroke. Biondi breathing every two. He's got plenty of smooth water. Can he hold on?
It is Matt Biondi in the lead. Biondi seems to have put away Gross. We'll see if Gross can come back. They now have 15 meters to swim. They now have 10 meters to swim. Matt Biondi going for the gold. John Sieben coming hard on the outside, but Biondi looks like he's going to take it to the wall. And they get Nesty, finally takes it in lane three at the very last moment. Matt Biondi finished second. Apparently Biondi's stretch wasn't quite there, and Nesty, that powerful little swimmer from Suriname, found a way, and he beat out Biondi in the very last stroke of this race. A major upset.
It was all in the finish, Don. Absolutely. No question about it. Biondi's got a plenty of the lead. Nesty's right here. You see him in lane three from the top. Biondi had the lead. He chose to take a long, easy glide to the finish. He probably should have taken four shorter strokes instead of three long ones. One, he's 10 meters away from the finish now, and he's got plenty of a lead. Keep your eye at this guy all the way to the wall, Nesty. Biondi's going to take two more strokes, and he coasts from here on in. He coasted 3 meters. Look at that glide. Nesty at the top said, no, I'm going to go. It's a sprint to the finish. Biondi deserves the loss because he could have won that race. He could have won that race. He should have swung head up, looked for the wall, five strokes out, and paced it correctly. He decided to glide with the dolphin kick.
There's Anthony Nesty.
That's American Dara Torres giving him a hug.
Yeah, they go to the University of Florida together. Anthony Nesty's a terrific kid. I've had a chance to spend a lot of time with him. He's very confident. And he puts Suriname on the map. Not that it's not already there, but it certainly hasn't been in swimming. As you see, Biondi finished second as Nesty got him with an Olympic record time. Jameson, the fastest qualifier from Great Britain, finished third. John Sieben, the Aussie, was fourth. And Michael Gross, who won at Los Angeles, did no better than fifth. We'll be back with more on the men's 100-meter butterfly in a moment.
Thank you. the spirit of the Olympics. Brought to you by MCI. Proof.
This is Don Cricky with John Neighbor back in Olympic swimming. Well, we've just had an upset in the men's 100-meter butterfly. Anthony Nesty from the little nation of Suriname on the north coast of South America, a swimmer also for the University of Florida, is Anthony. He touched out, and you'll see him in three down from the top of the screen. That's Anthony Nesty. Matt Biondi, the United States, is leading as they go to the wall and apparently feels he has it won. He strokes easily and stretches out, does not take the other stroke, and Nesty, with that powerful stroke, gets into the wall first and just edges out Matt Biondi for the gold. And there is Suriname, which now has its first Olympic gold medal winner. And we're going to meet him along with Matt Biondi as we go down to John.
Thanks, Don. Congratulations, Anthony. Any special significance that this is the first medal for your country?
Well, I'm very happy to be in here and win the first medal and all. And I'm just excited right now. Can't believe it.
Did you have any idea you were that close to the lead?
Well, I knew I was out pretty slow. I mean, not slow, but I knew I was out maybe fourth or fifth place at a 50. And I tried, all I could do is bring it home, and I did.
Well, congratulations. Best of luck rest of the meet.
Thanks a lot.
Okay. Unfortunately, Matt Biondi, who was here to give us a few comments, was pulled away to do the award ceremony, so we'll perhaps get a comment from him later. Don?
Okay, John, so we have Anthony Nesty, winner of gold in the men's 100-meter butterfly. Biondi, who seemed to have it won, losing in the final moments, and the third finisher, Andy Jameson. Now from Olympic Park Swimming Pool, it's back to Bryant Gumbel. Bryant? Thank you, Bryant. We're ready for the medal ceremony as the three top finishers in the men's 100-meter butterfly come out, led by Anthony Nesty of Suriname. That is Matt Biondi of the United States, who seemingly had the race won and kind of cruised to the wall when Nesty overpowered with that last stroke. So Matt Biondi now has bronze and silver, winning silver in this event. The third finisher was Andy Jameson.
It was a thrilling race all the way to the finish. Biondi all ahead. He's got about a meter, 3 feet on Nesty. Nesty's right here from Suriname. Nesty never stops. He just keeps turning out that rapid turnover between them. Andy Jameson, he breathes every stroke and he's looking very long. But from this point in, Biondi coasts. Nesty just keeps on coming a little bit faster and hits the wall first. Mikhail Gross, zero medals in two swims.
Yeah, Gross now is a fifth place finisher in two events, in the 200 free and in the event he won gold in at Los Angeles. This one, the 100-meter butterfly. The fourth finisher today was John Sieben of Australia, who is closing fast right next to Nesty, and Gross fifth.
Representative. Now looking at Nesty, he's got as many, Suriname has won as many medals as the United States in swimming, and he doesn't even look like it's sunk in yet. Either he's a stone face and keeps his emotions well under control, or it just hasn't really hit him yet.
As Brian was pointing out earlier in the coverage, the Olympic band had to learn a lot of national anthems. And fortunately, of the 160 they learned, they recorded the one for Suriname, which has never been played before at an Olympic Games. But today, the biggest man in the nation of Suriname is 5'10" Anthony Nesty. Olympic gold in the 100-meter butterfly. Unflappable, friendly. Native language is Dutch, but you'd never know it. As you heard him when he talked to John a little bit ago, he speaks absolutely perfect English. Never wanted to be a swimmer. Said his dad used to take him to the pool when he's about 8 years old and just point at the water. Get in and go.
You know, Don, he's coached by Randy Reese, who is now one of the assistant coaches on the U.S. Olympic team, also the head coach at the University of Florida. This is maybe something we can get into later in the week, how many foreign athletes are training on American soil under the tutelage of American coaches and are winning gold medals away from American swimmers.
Biondi has a lot to be proud of. He has two medals in two events so far. This is not his specialty, and he was very close to gold. His best events coming up, the shorter freestyles and the relays.
You know, in both swims, Matt Biondi has beaten everybody in the field that he was supposed to have to beat to win gold. And he comes up short.
There's Andy Jameson, the man who is looking to be the upsetter. He knows Biondi well. Jameson swam collegiately at Arizona State. Matt Biondi at Cal Berkeley. And as Brian pointed out, Anthony Nesty will begin his sophomore year at the University of Florida, where he'll swim for them, the Gators, next season. Not a bad guy to have going for you.
L'hymne nationale du Suriname.
I wonder what the song is going to sound like. I've never heard it.
The national anthem of Suriname.
Well, there's one guy who knows what it sounds like. It's never sounded better. Anthony Nesty, who moments ago established himself as the greatest sports hero in the history of his country, Suriname. We'll be back with the games of the 24th Olympiad in a moment.